中英联合声明作为一个历史文件，已经不再具有任何现实意义。对中国中央政府对香港特区的管理也不具备任何约束力。英方对回归后的香港没有主权，没有治权，也没有监督权。
Police have been clashing, as you can see, with pro-democracy protesters. I know that you have tweeted about that earlier on today, Foreign Secretary. What is your message to the authorities there?
Well, my starting point is that I have never had to fight for my freedom in my life. And my dad was in the Navy, and he and his generation were really responsible for winning the Cold War, and they knew what it was like to be on the front line against freedom. And he taught me we can never take our freedoms for granted. So when I look at those situations that we've just seen and those terrible scenes in Hong Kong, my heart goes out to...people who do have to fight for their freedoms and who are worried they could lose very, very precious way of life.
Even if they use violence?
Well, I don't support violence in any circumstances, but I understand their worries about changes that are happening in Hong Kong. And when I talked to the Chinese government about this, you know, they put out a statement last week saying this is an internal affair and it's not for Britain to meddle in it.But we signed an agreement with China in 1984. It was actually Margaret Thatcher and Deng Xiaoping who signed the joint declaration, which guaranteed what's called the one country, two systems promise for 50 years for Hong Kong. And that has been the foundation of Hong Kong's success. So I really hope that there aren't changes in Hong Kong that undermine that agreement, which is a legally binding agreement.Between Britain and China. And as I said today, we stand behind what was in that agreement. We stand behind the freedoms that it enshrined, and we stand behind the people of Hong Kong.
Doesn't necessarily
look... 7月1日，我們見到兩個截然不同的場面。一個是一個和平理性的遊行，體現了香港自由、多元、包容的核心價值。另一個是令人痛心、震驚的違法暴力場面，有示威者由早上開始一直就同警方對峙，堵塞道路，以一些不明的液體嚟到攻擊我哋嘅警察。去到中午時分，情況急轉直下，示威者以極暴力嘅方式衝擊立法會大樓。我哋睇到嘅係用鐵枝、鐵箱車破壞立法會大樓嘅玻璃外牆，用一啲帶有毒性嘅化學粉末嚟到攻擊警察。及後去到晚上，更加係強行闖入咗立法會大樓，並喺裏面大肆嚟到去破壞，包括損毀咗莊嚴嘅議事廳同埋區徽，以及。立法會現任前任主席的畫像，這些目無法紀的暴力行為嚴重影響香港法治的核心價值，我對此感到十分憤慨和痛心，並要予以強烈的譴責。我相信市民都是有同感的。警方處理昨日整日的暴力行為一直表現克制，但是對於任何違法行為，我們必定會追究到底。
在香港特區發生的暴力衝擊立法會大樓、肆意損壞立法會設施的行為，是践踏法治、危害社會秩序的嚴重違法行為，我們對此予以強烈的譴責。中央政府堅決的支持香港特区政府和警方依法处置。我已经连续两天对亨特先生涉港的错误言论做出了回应，表达了中方的强烈不满和坚决反对。但他似乎还沉浸在昔日英国殖民者的幻想当中，还执迷于居高临下对他国事务指手画脚的恶习当中，依然不思悔改。 继续信口雌黄。今天索性在这里我就多说几句。第一，关于中英联合声明，我要再次强调，随着香港回归祖国，声明中所规定的与英方有关的权利和义务已经全部履行完毕。1997年7月1日，中国恢复对香港行使主权，中国政府依照宪法和基本法对香港实行管制，英方对回归后的香港一无主权，二无治权，三无监督权，根本不存在任何所谓的责任。英方动不动就以守护者自居，这纯粹是自作多情，痴心妄想。第二，所谓香港居民的自由是英方争取来的，这种说法简直是厚颜无耻。我想问问亨特先生，在英国对香港进行殖民统治期间，香港有何民主可言？港人连上街游行的权利都没有。恰恰是在香港回归之后，中国政府依照宪法和基本法切实贯彻落实一国两制、港人治港、高度自治方针，保障香港居民依法享有前所未有的民主权利和自由。第三，7月1日在香港特区发生的暴力冲击立法会事件是践踏法治、危害社会秩序的严重违法行为。亨特先生罔顾事实，居然称特区政府是在镇压，这完全是在颠倒黑白。我要问问亨特先生，如果英国议会被围攻、被闯入、被破坏，英方会听之任之、坐视不管吗？如果像亨特先生所说那样，这就是所谓的民主，他是否认为严密把守英国议会的警察应该撤走，让常年站在议会对面的示威者进入英国议会？他是否也认为英国警方处理2011年8月发生在伦敦的骚乱是镇压呢？最后，我要再次强调，香港是中华人民共和国的特别行政区，香港事务纯属中国内政，任何外国组织、政府组织和个人都不得以任何方式干涉。我们希望英方，特别是亨特先生，不要再不自量力、粗暴干涉香港事务，这注定是徒劳的。